Eric Mwesigwa, a border rider and a resident of Kazo in Kampala, is said to be the recent survivor of the alleged abductions. Mwesigwa, who is currently in a lot of pain due to the wounds on his chest, is said to have returned home this weekend, having disappeared for a number of days. Mwesigwa narrates the painful ordeal of what he went through. He claims to have been abducted on 31st of last month by a gentleman who posed as a customer, only to lead him to a gang of unknown people who put him in a drone and started torturing him.
Like this. Then I stopped my bike. I was stuck at that time. I saw some two guys. They came out when they was putting a mask, like they covering their faces like this. I was seeing just only eyes and here, like a small nose here like this. Then they carried me on my bike. They put me inside on the car. Then my phone falls down. That immediately I first think on my wife and my number's wife. Then I try to call my phone for my wife. The guy they came and put close my face. After that, I didn't understand what's going on.
Mwesigwa's father alleges that during that tough time, they questioned him a lot about Bobi Wine.
He was asking me that, why do you support Bobi Wine? What are you planning to do for this government, for President Museveni? For me, I was telling them, I don't know. For me, I'm just a supporter for NUP. I don't know everything.
During a news conference today, the party president of National Unity Platform, Robert Kyagulanyi, has condemned the continuous human rights abuse.
The commission, the Uganda Human Rights Commission, which is supposed to be defending human rights, is part of the human rights violators by denying that there are abductions here, and it is a moment of shame for the head of the Human Rights Commission, Madame Wagadia. It should be not such words coming from her mouth.
Kyagulanyi has asked the Uganda Human Rights Commission to intervene.
Many are still missing. Many have been abducted. They are missing. Many are reportedly killed. We continue to demand the release of all those that have been abducted.
Report compiled by Juliet Namuwaya for the news.